गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश. सो दिस इज द टेक्स्ट बुक रिलेटेड टू 8th क्लास, 8th स्टैंडर्ड. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी और नो अबाउट द फर्स्ट यूनिट ऑफ दिस क्लास एंड द थीम ऑफ द फर्स्ट यूनिट इज फैमिली. सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आई वुड लाइक टू शो यू that there are three lessons, three readings related with first unit, and they are: first is A reading, tattered blanket; second one is B reading, my mother, and it is a poem; and the last one, C reading, it is a letter to a friend. Okay students, so now here in this textbook we have almost 8 units, and each and every unit is related with a particular theme. As you can see in this textbook, this unit is consist of a family, the theme of a family. And at the same time, you can also see a pictorial description over in this page, which is reflecting us about a family. So here you can see in this page a family. Okay, so it is a page related with style sheet, which is called as a style sheet. At the same time, if you go ahead with the next page, here we have a face sheet. So here both the pictures are related with the same theme. What it is? A family. So here, now let us know what is a family actually. So here you can see how they are seen, how they are seen, how they are looking among. Yes, they are very happy. How they are? They are very happy. Okay, so now children, here first of all we have to know about what is a family. Okay, each and every individual is having a family. As usually you as well as me to have the families, but let us know, even though we are existing in the families, but let us know, for example, what is a family. So a family is a group of people who are closely related to one another by blood, marriage or adoption. A set of parents and their children is also called as a family. Okay children, so what is a family? A family is a group of people who are closely related to one another. It may be by blood, that means from generations to generations. And at the same time, when a newly married girl enters into the new family, it creates, it generates a new family. And or by adoption, if in a family there is no children, there are no children, there is also a choice of having the adoption of children who can continue the generations. Okay, so here a family is a group of people who are closely related to one another by blood, marriage or adoption. Otherwise, in simple words, we can also say a set of parents and their children is called a family. Alright children, now is it clear for you what is a family? Yes. So family is a group of people closely related to one another. Now here, as we got awareness about family, here the families are also of different types. Okay, families are also of different types. Let us see what they are. Okay, how they are divided. Okay. Okay children, so here in the earlier question we came to know about what is family, and now here we are with the types of families. So here we have two types of families. How many types? Two types of families. So they are small family, small family, otherwise they are also called as nuclear family also. Okay, and big family. Here big family is also known as joint family. Okay children, so how many types of families are there? Two types of families are there. First one is small family and the second one is big family. So children, here is a definition for small family and a big family. Small family is also called as a nuclear family. At the same time, big family is also called as a joint family. So now here in small family, the members of the family are consist of father, mother and two or three children. Okay children, just focus. Consists, a small family consists of a father, mother and two or three children. Whereas in joint family or big family, the members consist of grandparents, parents, uncles, aunts and their children. Okay children, So joint family has a larger group of family members, whereas in small family there are less people, only parents and their children. Whereas in joint family it is a combination of grandpa, generations to generations, okay, 3 to 2 generations, 1 to 3 generations are going to be existing in the joint family. Okay children, now I'd like to show you the face sheet. So see here children, here the pictorial description is related with the two families. Can you describe what type of families these both are? Yes, exactly correct. As I have given the definition, now you may be able to get the idea of what is a joint family and what is a small family. Yes, the first picture is related with a small family or a nuclear family, whereas the second picture is related with a joint family or a big family, because here you can see the group of people are more in number and they are grandparents, parents and uncles and aunts along with their children. Okay, now children, which family do you belongs to? So please put your answer in a book. Okay, so to which family do you belong? Okay, now here at the same time here we have got some questions related with it. So first question already we have completed. Now what type of families do we find in our present society? Yes children, can you give the example? Can you express what type of families do we find in our present society? Yes, most of the families have been divided from their joint families and setting up the nuclear or small families. There are many reasons. Okay children, there are many reasons. So for the dividing of joint families into nuclear families, it may be due to the educational purpose or for the better life or for their employment purpose. Here the joint families have got divided and setting up the joint nuclear families. Okay children, now here they have also posed a question, why? Yes, we have also described or discussed about what is the reason for dividing or becoming the small families. Now which family do you like and why? So here is a question related to you children. So which type of family do you like and why? So please comment in your book. Please write, describe in your book in your own words. Okay children, so this is the part of our face sheet explanation. I hope you people, all of you, have got the idea about what is a small family and a big family and what are the difference between the small family and a big family. And at the same time here is an oral discourse debate. Small families are happy families. Please try to give your own idea regarding small families are happy families. If you are existing in joint family, just compare with the small families and try to get the idea of how you people are related with small families and big families, because you know your own ideology of spending your time and spending your years of experiences in joint families or small families. So supporting your answer to the debate, small families are happy families, please put your answer in the notebook. Okay, so let us meet again in our second part of A Reading the Tattered Blanket. Thank you.